This is News Talk 980 CKNW.
So interest rates in the news again today as the Bank of Canada Governor Stephen Poloz spoke about the state of the Canadian economy.
And if you're one of those misery loves company types, Michael Campbell, host of Money Talks, Canada's top-rated financial show, will make you feel better with yet another example of financial incompetence in Canada's largest province.
Yeah, maybe no surprise that the Bank of Canada held rates steady for the 15th consecutive time today. What do you think it's going to take to move rates even higher, Michael?
Well, I think the bottom line is he's still talking about the uncertainty surrounding the U.S. I mean, we now have the NAFTA renegotiation. It's official. It's going to go. We have the ongoing softwood lumber dispute. The longer that goes on, then you're going to start feeling that negative impact in our economy. I think the big thing, though, is that still, you know, Trump's pro-business agenda is being brought into question, at least delayed, especially U.S. tax changes. Most recently, by the way, and just today, by the Republican Senate, who said they're not touching that until they revamp Obamacare first, which means they got to make changes to the bill that the Congress did. But, you know, just as an aside, you know what I find incredible? I'm hearing all these Canadians sort of defending the existing Obamacare bill, and I just sort of laugh at it. I mean, what we're really talking about are bills that are created by lobbyists. And, you know, we seem to be completely naive to that. A couple of great stats here. I mean, first of all, the U.S. healthcare industry is $4 trillion. But in 2009, there were 1,750 companies and organizations, and they hired 4,525 lobbyists to try and influence Obamacare. That works out to about 8 for every member of Congress. Wow. They spent $1.2 billion. Now we got to the revamp. I just looked at the numbers. In the first 3 months of this year, the 5 largest publicly traded insurers, just the insurers, spent a combined $6.2 million. The top 8 pharmaceutical companies doubled the money they spent lobbying. The bottom line is that's what you're really dealing with here, is lobbyists influence politicians who then make changes to Obamacare. But they're saying they will not handle the tax side of Trump's agenda until that's done. So who knows when.
Now, Mike, when you look at the Canadian economy for the first quarter, we did pretty well. So rates going up, the question is why?
You're absolutely right. I mean, we've had it's kind of surprising how well we did in the first, like, 4 months of the year, in the quarter, et cetera. But this is the deal. Is today the Bank of Canada, Governor Poloz said that he expects the economy to actually slow down. That pace would not be maintained, that we saw in that first quarter. And the things he's looking at are this. We have very little wage pressure going on. We still have excess capacity in the economy. There's no inflationary pressure. So when you say, when will he finally pull the trigger, I kind of think we got to get above that 2% inflation for him to see there's a problem. The other thing is, I think he'd like to see the U.S. raise their rates, and there's still, good probability that could happen as soon as June. But, keep in mind, we have had this weak Canadian dollar. He does not want to see that go up at this point. He doesn't want to have that stronger dollar until we get a fuller recovery in manufacturing exports. So I think that's what he's on about at this point. So I still, we're still waiting.
Well, yeah, and I was saying to friends the other day, there's no way interest rates can stay this low forever, obviously. When do you think the rates are going to go up?
I think you're still seeing the consensus, Linda, at the second quarter of the next year. Barring any big surprises, then it could get delayed further. But, yeah, I still think we're looking at the second quarter of this year. And I still sit there and sort of shake my head. We've glossed over some of the problems within the Canadian economy by simply having, a huge discount on what we get paid for work and the goods because we've had a decline in the loonie. So, that should have helped our exports. We got the record low interest rates, as you just said. I mean, that should have helped the exports. It's been pretty darn mediocre up to this point. Maybe with the oil prices, if they can stay above that $50 range, maybe that will help growth.
Let's talk about the talk that President Trump wants to sell half of the U.S. oil reserves. That's got a lot of people worried.
Yeah, it does, because, of course, that's supply. And then that'll act as another damper on oil prices. Canadians, our economy needs higher oil prices at this point. Yeah, the deal was this. They had this strategic oil reserve. They set it up in the 70s to protect the U.S. from oil supply shocks. But now we've seen this massive jump in U.S. oil production. So, they don't really need it, according to the Trump administration and many others, by the way, who would agree with them. Their proposal is to sell about half of that oil reserve over the next 10 years, looking to raise about $17 billion. So that would be a damper on oil prices, but maybe even more so, you got China. China's been building their huge strategic oil reserves. They've been big buyers over the last few years, but what if they slow down? That'll put, you know, prices, down a little bit. I see, I'm personally still in that camp that thinks we're going to get one more correction in oil prices. That may be what Stephen Poloz is also a little bit worried about and why he thinks we'll have lower growth, say, going in the second half of the year than we've experienced so far.
And staying with the energy theme here, you got a bit of a doozy when it comes to financial incompetence in Ontario. What's that all about?
Oh, I mean, we should still smug, shouldn't we? They got the Leafs in the playoffs. We didn't get the Canucks in the playoffs, and they feel pretty good about it. Well, you know what? I'll take the Canucks, and I'll take our energy rates, because they have had a disaster when it looks at their track record on electricity rates. This is why the Wynne government, they're going to have an election coming up soon, so she was trying to bribe voters by promising a 25% reduction on their bills. You know, the old free something, in this case, free electricity, basically. Well, we got the Auditor General's report today, and it is a doozy. They're calling the Liberals' so-called Fair Hydro Plan is going to ultimately cost people in Ontario $21 billion over the next three decades. Why? Because it's going to cost $45 billion, but they're only going to save $24 billion for ratepayers, so you got a $21 billion net expense. But this was my favorite part. The Auditor General says those numbers only hold true if the province is able to achieve and maintain a balanced budget over the next 20 years. Because if it doesn't, they say that subsidy is going to end up costing me $69 and $93 billion. Oof. I mean, my God. I mean, the interesting part is this. I still say that despite this report, a big chunk of Ontarian voters won't care. They'll take the freebie because the bottom line, we've done this many times before, they think, hey, I'm not going to be paying that bill. We're passing it to the next generation. And my goodness, that is quite a pass off, you know, to the next generation. But it clearly doesn't bother some people.
Michael Campbell's Money Talks is going to be back on CKNW this Saturday. You can listen in live and listen to past episodes right now at cknw.com. Mike, always a pleasure.
My pleasure.
Vancouver's News, Vancouver's Talk. This is News Talk 980 CKNW.